The next item of business is consideration of Parliamentary Bureau Motion 15228 on approval of an SSI, and I ask Jamie Hepburn on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau to move the motion.
Move, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Minister. And I now call on Tim Eagle. Up to 3 minutes, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And I just draw the members' attention to my register of interest as a farmer and former land agent. The Scottish Conservatives share the concerns of many in the farming industry in regards to the proposals within the regulation before us, the Rural Development Continuation of Operation Miscellaneous Amendments Scotland Regulations 2024. Now, there is no doubt that the proposed regulations are important. I want to clarify that. They seek to extend the operation of rural development support schemes, such as the Scottish Rural Development Programme, the SRDP, and the Less Favoured Area Support Scheme, LFAS, a lifeline for many farmers, beyond their current expiry date of 31st of December 2024. But the regulations suggest a new end date of 31st of December 2030. A consultation by the Rural Affairs and Islands Committee raised concerns that this was an unnecessarily lengthy extension, especially considering that the Government's own agricultural route map suggests 2027 at the latest would be more appropriate. Equally, many stakeholders have raised concerns that LFAS continues on a 2018 payment rate and it is in need of rebasing to ensure it reflects changes to agricultural businesses. My concern is that in the round, this SSSI simply sends the wrong message to the industry about its future. Sadly, we're not allowed to change an SSSI or to amend it, but the Scottish Conservatives have continuously asked the Scottish Government to rewrite these regulations in response to the concerns raised. The Government have chosen not to do so, and whilst I stress we want to see payments and the schemes continue, we cannot actively support this SSI today for the above reasons. Thank you.
Thank you, and I call on Jim Fairley to respond. Up to 3 minutes, Minister.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Presiding Officer, I want to make 3 points abundantly clear. This regulation does not cut across nor replace the published agricultural reform route map. The route map is a living document that sets out the phased transition from legacy cap support into a new four-tier framework. It sets out in detail the changes for 2025, and we laid the regulation on this last week. The route map will further be updated in 2025 with the detailed proposed for greening changes for 2026. The route map states that legacy Scottish Rural Development Programme schemes will continue with no change until at least 2026, with further engagement required on how the support may be delivered from 2027. We have committed to the route map to keep updated, and we will continue to provide more clarity as and when it becomes available from co-development with rural partners within the Agricultural Reform Programme. No, I won't. All this regulation does is extend the legal basis for continued SRDP support at programme level until 2030. The regulation is simple and straightforward by design. It does not change policy, it does not change outcomes, it does not change payments. That was never the intent, nor what we publicly committed to. The regulation will allow us to provide the support for less favoured areas, support for crofting, support for agri-environment, support for forestry and support for community-led local development, to name but a few. If this is not approved, there is no support, no phased transition, only a cliff edge. As that stark, this Parliament during the last term extended the legal basis for the continued SRDP support until the end of 2024. It is now for this Parliament to vote to do the same thing until 2030. To be clear, 2030 does not mean no change. It does not mean every scheme will run as is in every year until 2030. What it means is that instead of constant cliff edges and annual visits to Parliament to extend schemes, we will instead be coming back here when there is a change to make or when we bring forward replacement support. This regulation is a pragmatic approach that provides continued assurance and a backstop. It enables us to focus our collective time and resource on the co-development of new support within the four-tier framework, using the powers of the Agriculture and Rural Communities Act, Scotland Act 2024. It delivers on our public commitments and what we consulted on. This regulation is essential as it underpins the route map and it enables the phased transition to take place. I hope that today we can provide some much-needed assurance to our farmers, crofters and land managers and show that, unlike elsewhere, the Scottish Parliament continues to value and to support them. Thank you.
Thank you. The question on this motion will be put at decision time. The next item of business is consideration of 8 Parliamentary Bureau motions, and I ask the Minister, on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau, to move motions 15229 on approval of a UKSI, 15230 and 15231 on approval of SSIs, 15232 and 15233 on committee membership, 15234 and 15235 on committee substitutes, and 15236 on Office of the Clerk.
Move, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Minister. And the question on these motions will be put at decision time, and there are five questions to be put as a result of today's business. The first is that Amendment 15205.2 in the name of Ros McCall, which seeks to amend Motion 15205 in the name of Natalie Dawn Innes on keeping the promise, be agreed. Are we all agreed? The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote, and there'll be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.